Once we have assigned oxidation numbers to elements in a reaction, we can then identify what is oxidized, what is reduced, what is the reducing agent, and what is the oxidizing agent. Oxidation is identified as the loss of electrons. A good mnemonic device for this is Leo the Lion Goes Grr. And so the loss of electrons is oxidation. Reduction is identified as the gain of electrons. So the Grr part is the gain of electrons is reduction. So again, realize these two have to go hand in hand. They have to happen together for a chemical reaction. So Leo the Lion Goes Grr is one mnemonic. You might have learned it as oil rig, where oxidation is loss and reduction is gain. The substance that gets oxidized is also called the reducing agent. And that's because when we use the word agent in chemistry, it is describing a substance that causes something else. So when we say reducing agent, we're referring to a substance that causes another one to be reduced. So that always has to be the opposite. Whatever gets oxidized will be the reducing agent. And vice versa, when we're describing the oxidizing agent, this is the substance that causes something else to be oxidized, therefore it would be reduced. Two key things to pay attention to as you're defining these. Elements are substances that get oxidized and reduced. Compounds are the oxidizing and reducing agents. So we're going to work through an example. In your slides, it's on this one, but to give me room to work, we're going to work through this one. Recognize in order to answer and identify what is oxidized, what is reduced, what is our oxidizing agent, and what is our reducing agent, before we can assign these, we of course have to identify oxidation numbers. So we're going to go through this equation and solve. For hydrogen, since it is ionic, we already know it's charged, so that's a plus one. For the permanganate, we solved that in the previous video. Here we know oxygen is our minus two, manganese came out to be a plus seven. Chloride is also in its ionic form, so that's a minus one. Manganese is also ionic, that's a plus two. HClO, we also solved in the previous video. So we know the value of each one, hydrogen's plus one, chlorine's plus one, oxygen's minus two, those all add up to zero for a neutral molecule. Same thing for water. We know that oxygen's a minus two and each hydrogen has to be a plus one. So now we can look at, sorry about that. We can look at what's happening to substances as this reaction proceeds. Notice the two that changed oxidation number are manganese. And what else? Hopefully you identified chlorine as the other element that changes. Notice as this reaction proceeds that manganese goes from a plus 7 to a plus 2. Its charge reduced. The only way that that can happen is with the gain of electrons. Right? To go from a plus 7 to a plus 2, it had to gain negatively charged electrons. And so the element that was reduced was the Mn plus 7. This is the required part of the answer. Optionally, if you want to add in what substance it came from, you can identify that it was in permanganate. The substance that was oxidized was then chloride. It has to be, but to figure out why, recognize that it went from a minus one to a plus one. Its charge increased. The only way for that to happen is for chloride to have lost electrons. So again, notice for identifying what's oxidized and reduced, I'm specifically writing elements. For my agents, I'm going to write the whole compound that was used in the reaction. Since chloride was oxidized, that means it must have caused the other substance to be reduced. Since I only have the form of chloride in this equation, since this is effectively a net ionic equation, that is all I can write. If I was given the cation that it was with, I would write that, but all I know is that chloride is my reducing agent. Therefore, my oxidizing agent has to be the manganese compound. Manganese was reduced, and so therefore my oxidizing agent is the permanganate ion. Again, I'm writing the entire compound that's listed in the equation. The other thing to note about all of your answer options here is that these can only be reactants. When you're asked to identify what's oxidized and what's reduced, oxidizing agent, reducing agent, your answer options are only the reactants. This slide is a great practice slide. So using these two equations, I encourage you to go through, assign oxidation numbers, and then identify what's oxidized, reduced, and each of the agents as listed up here. So the answers are listed. Please try to practice these by covering the answers and testing yourself. The last topic for this video will be discussing how we balance redox reactions. As I like to do, I'm going to go through the long version and then show you the shortcut. So recognize that we have a simple redox reaction here. We have a substance being oxidized and one being reduced. For our long version, what I'm going to do is separate this equation into two half reactions, and then I will balance the equation so that my electrons cancel out. Then we'll recombine these half reactions into one equation. Then I'm going to come back to this slide and show you the shortcut version. I will also come back and note and clarify this comment. All right, so looking at this equation, again, I want to break this into two half reactions. To do that, I want to figure out what is oxidized and what is reduced. Recognize in this equation that copper is zero. Copper in the solid form is zero. It goes to a +2, and so the copper solid is what got oxidized. By process of elimination, it means the silver had to be reduced. To do that, we double check our oxidation numbers. Silver goes from a +1 to a 0, so it did get reduced. And now I'm going to complete writing my half reactions. So a half reaction is showing the transfer of electrons, whether each substance is gaining or losing them. Remember that we defined oxidation as the loss of electrons. The loss of electrons indicates that those electrons are given off as products in the reaction. And notice that each equation still has to be balanced. Since copper is going from a 0 to a +2, it means that copper had to lose 2 electrons so that my charge on the right side balances out to 0. For my reduction half reaction, remember the gain of electrons is reduction. When we describe the gain of electrons, that means those are reactants. Again, to balance charges, silver only needs to gain 1 electron to balance this half reaction. The last step in balancing our equation is to balance this so that our electrons cancel out. So electrons have to be on opposite sides of the equation. But now what we do is multiply through by coefficients so that the electrons will cancel out. If I multiply this second equation through by 2, I get a coefficient of 2 on everything. Notice now my electrons cancel. And now I can write my full balanced chemical equation. So two silver ions plus one copper solid will react to produce two silver solid plus one copper 2+ ion. Recognize that when we balance, we're balancing both atoms. So I have the coefficient of 2 in front of both silver atoms to balance those, and we're balancing charges. Recognize on the left-hand side, I have a total of, I have a total of a 2+. On the right-hand side, when I add everything up, I also have a total of a 2+. All right, now for the shorthand version. If we go back to this original equation, notice that we're given net ionic equation. And the short version is to simply balance an equation using charges. So I know that my charges are not balanced. I have a plus one on reactants. I have a 2+ on the products. To balance that, I need a coefficient of 2 on the silver. Now the hard part and a common mistake is that students will balance the charge, but then forget to go through and balance the atoms as well. So notice this equation I have written here gives us the same result that we wrote down here for our final balancing. Two notes about our half reactions though. One is when we balanced, notice that in both of our equations, we ended up with 2 moles of electrons, right? Coefficient of 2 means that we have 2 moles of electrons here. When we get into calculations in this chapter, the N value that we use will be moles of electrons. So the value for N is determined as the coefficient on your electrons when your equations are balanced. In other words, I had to have 2 electrons in each equation in order to get them to balance or to cancel. That gives me my N value. The second thing that I want to point out is as we go through this chapter, we will be using half reactions, an oxidation half reaction and a reduction half reaction. So it's helpful to get used to seeing those now.